it's all right. I love you.
People can find us here. Sorry about that. I'm not sure what's going on with Restream.
Yeah, if people could just post the YouTube link into Twitch or somehow let the people know, that'd be great. Okay, so because we're running a little late, we're going to jump right into it. We're going to start with Dollclaw, and they are amazing. Performance of folks from LA, and they just released a new single, but we're gonna start with their set, and then after that we're gonna talk about Rogers and Rosewater, what they're up to, and show a little video, and then we'll keep rolling. So thanks you guys, sorry we're running a little late.
First song is Angelica, second song is Thorns. First song I just released as a single on the 18th of December. The next will be part of the full EP released in February. Okay, let's do this.
Well, thank you so much. So we're going to just skip into some more music really fast, and then we'll do our donation stuff. So we're going to put Punk Bunny up next, and if you don't know Punk Bunny, you should. He's wonderful, and here we go.
I'm in the mesh, I'm human again. Familiar faces, familiar places. Holes in my shoes, holes in my pockets. Nothing's changed, I think nothing has changed.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So much wonderful stuff from Gil, and you can check him out on Instagram, and just really fun, crazy performances. And I just want to really quick do, we want to talk about Rogers and Rosewater really fast. I just posted in the comments on YouTube the donation info, and we have some auction items tonight. We have t-shirts, we have masks, we have patches. I'm going to show you all of those really fast. So here's some patches. These were done by Moira Scar. And if you make a $15 donation, we'll send you one of those. And we also have, so what you can do is just send a screenshot to my email here. And bewarecat@gmail.com. And we'll send you one of these patches. And the other things we have T-shirts, not the dog, but the t-shirts. These are Supermoon t-shirts, and we have mediums and larges, and they're kind of unisex and kind of like, you might not wear them as like a muscle tee, but you would kind of wear them like if you wanted to relax. So if you do a $20 donation, you can get one of these t-shirts. I have a limited amount, but if I get enough requests for them, I will print some more. And let's see here, we also have some masks. Here they go. These were designed by Moira Scar, and they were donated by Mats, who is an awesome artist in the Bay Area. So if you want one of those, again, do a donation of $15 and email me at bewarecrat@gmail.com. So thank you so much, you guys, for donating. And here's a little quick video about what Bopa and her crew does in Oakland. Thank you so much, and we're going to go right into our next artist, which is Dakota Newt, who's a wonderful, amazing performance, but then also painter and sort of sculptor and installation, live installation person. He always has different kinds of shapes and paintings that he puts onto himself and then photographs or goes out into the world. And this one is a... an ode to gay love, and it's him lip syncing to the theme to Sleepaway Camp. So enjoy. Thank you. Thank you so much, Dakota. That was amazing. And you should go check out his Instagram and his world, because he's got so much amazing stuff happening. And he was really awesome to make that video brand new, fresh for us. And we have next up, we have Bice, who just has a new album that came out called Nagas du Sey, if I'm saying that with French. But he's a really wonderful artist. They have a new video for us as well, and here it comes.
check, 1, 2.
You can see it, but I broke my toe.
We can. It's a real rock star right there. Good job.
All right, thanks, man.
Thanks, the bathroom cam. We loved it. Thank you so much, Bice.
All right, next up, we have the mighty George Chin, comedian extraordinaire, music label dude extraordinaire, musician extraordinaire. Tonight he's doing some comedy, and I believe he has a PowerPoint presentation of some type. Let's check in with George, see what he's got rolling.
Yeah, hi. Hi, guys. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, hold on, I guess. So let's switch over.
Can you hear me?
Where are you? Okay.
Is my audio coming through?
You
are. Hey, George.
And our audio is coming through.
Hi,
too.
How's it going? Yeah. Hi, it's George. Yeah, thanks for having me on the show. I used to do comedy. I used to do a lot of things, but you know, there's no live comedy really happening right now in the pandemic period. So, I've kind of had to pivot. I'm trying out some side hustles, and actually, what I wanted to do. I know there's like maybe like 50 people watching. You guys, maybe you are all interested in some of my business ideas. Do you mind if I just share my business ideas with you guys?
That'd be fantastic.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Yeah. Great. Okay, so this next one, I know we've all been there. Hey, you ever go to a restaurant and you get those disposable chopsticks and you break them in half and then one half is way bigger than the other half? We all know what that's like, right? Well, I've got a solution for that, actually. Just piece of sandpaper attached to the chopstick holder. I've looked into this. I've been saying this for decades. Even went so far as to buy sandpaper. What I've not found is a restaurant willing to partner with me on this because it is prohibitively expensive. But that is one of my business ideas. If you guys want to come at me on Twitter at George the Chen. We can talk about this great new. Who doesn't want to like buff and polish something next to someone in a restaurant?
Yeah.
Outdoors. Just spread sawdust all over someone's miso soup. I think that's a good plan.
It's a good idea.
Right, so this is another idea. Thank you. This idea, and you feel free to take some of these. Some of these I do need copyright. I need my cut. But hey, who doesn't like onions? Weirdos don't. Who doesn't like onions, guys? Everyone loves onions. So my next business idea is just something I came up with called the 5 onion salad. It includes shallots, so it's pushing the limit of what you consider to be an onion. I guess this is more like a recipe, but you know, you can make money off recipes, right? Isn't that? That New York Times lady, that's what she. All right. Also, don't forget the green onions. You need to have a bit of green in there. Okay. Now, this one is more like a franchise idea. I think we could all maybe like four or five of us could chip in on one franchise for this. But this has existed for a while. It's not really purely my idea. But I think it's something to jump on, which is the Halloween Superstore, guys. There is a
Halloween Spirit Store.
Yeah, there it's real chill for 11 months out of the year if you own one of these things. So the secret to doing a Halloween Superstore is you find an empty storefront, and guess what, guys? There's going to be a lot of empty storefronts come October 2021. Tons of empty storefronts. Maybe some of your favorite music venues will become Spirit Halloween Superstores. And so I think we just get in on the ground floor of this trend before it takes off. My other favorite thing about a Halloween Superstore is it's also like a costume for a building. So like the building gets to dress up like the ghost of a formerly thriving.
I like that.
It's kind of creepy, man.
Yeah, pretty creepy. All right. So here's another thing. Like, you know, a lot of the business ideas these days are about disrupting, right? You got to disrupt. You find an industry and you disrupt it. So I was thinking about who thinks like going to the pet store is depressing, right? Like you maybe just go to like pick up your pet supplies, but then there's always like animals for sale. Like I kept thinking about like how sad this one little chinchilla was. I keep seeing him at the pet store and he seemed real lonely. And like, I mean, he's totally out of his element. He's not like in South America. And I was just like, well, you should take this guy and get him a friend. And I got this guy a buddy. Turns out they reproduce. So they created a big chonker guy. I call him a chonkchilla. And now I have too many chinchillas, everyone. If you are interested in a cool pet or whatever you want to do with it, I've started a little business called Chen's Chill Chinchillas. We send you two chinchillas. Here's how it's going to work. If you're interested in this, definitely DM me. I'm going to send you a couple chinchillas in the mail. They practically take care of themselves. You don't really need to worry about much. They'll eat the box that they come in. It's fine. And then you send me back a cut of your profits from your pets. You know, it's sort of like if you're in the top red nodes here, I'm pointing out the red. Like, obviously, I'm the blue node. I'm the chief chinchilla. And then you could be one of the founder circles. Those are the two red circles at the top. And then everyone below sends their profits up through the chain. And if that looks familiar to you,
it's kind of an MLM or something.
Yeah, it's basically, guys, I recreated an MLM. It's a multi-level marketing, which, all right, I psyched you out. That is how it works. That all is basically right. How it works. There's a red person, then there's some blue people, and then there's all the drones that are like feeding the blue people up to the red people. I know about this. Sounds like you guys know about this too. I was actually born into a multi-level marketing family. I'm writing a memoir about it. I'm calling it a multi-level memoir. And I'd like to say that I am a tea tree oil heir. I don't know if anyone here is familiar with the Melaleuca line. It's a pretty famous line of lotions and ointments and creams and snack bars. And I'm pretty sure every orifice I have has been touched by a tea tree oil at some point. I was born into a family of these products. There's so many Melaleuca products. So being a second generation MLMer, I've actually had to educate myself and get out of the game. And what I found is a lot of Americans have made their way through this MLM system, the multi-level marketing system. So I've actually been going to support groups for it. A lot of ex-MLM support groups. It's like we trauma bonded, it's a group therapy thing. So actually what's happened as a product of all these meetings, we've started organizing. A lot of the former multi-level marketing people, we started organizing, and I'm just letting you guys hear it first. We have our podcast, guys. We've got a new podcast. It's just called Say No to MLMs. We're just putting out new content all the time. It's really fun. We really break down the game. We really educate people and what to spot. And in fact, it's been pretty successful to the point where actually the best way to support us now is to become part of our Patreon. So actually, there's different levels to the Patreon. Obviously, there's the one level, $1 a month that gets you in the ground floor. That's fine. That's great for most people. Some of you want a challenge. You want to go up to the $50 level. And guess what? You receive a surprise in the mail. And that's going to be from our founder, who we'll get to. We'll get to our founder in a little bit. All right. So we actually have swag. We created a bunch of swag. There's Say No to MLM's t-shirts. We even got some Corona masks and stuff. And if you are not satisfied at the $50 level of the Patreon, well, there are actually some retreats that we organize. There's some retreats we organize. There's an annual retreat that we hold, and people come in from all over the place. It's really fun. We just do workshops, talk about our experiences, being caught up in the MLMs, what to spot. And they're all really fun. And actually, it happens to be the weekend of the birthday of our founder. So this is our founder, Kenneth.
Kenneth!
Kenneth.
Yeah!
He's a genius, been in the game for so long. He's really schooled me and everything I know about MLMs. He does ask that we call him Liege. So you can call him Kenneth until you meet him. Then you got to call him Liege. He's a great guy. Really learned so much from Liege. And actually, the conferences go on all year round. And we actually have an official compound in Vallejo, a lot of people wearing polo shirts and lanyards. It's that kind of space, guys. People love it. People hang out there all year long. Like, even now, people are there. I mean, I was just there the other day, and this is a photo, like, from recently. We think of it as our second home, really, and Liege is kind of like a father figure, you know? Like the father we never really had. And
actually, what a guy!
Yeah, we just had a conference. This is a week ago, guys. We just had a conference. Obviously, you know, we had a great time. Everyone just really getting real close to each other, just breathing on each other. It's been really awesome. And we had such a good time. In fact, a lot of us are getting matching tattoos. I don't know if you guys are a fan of the matching tattoo. I don't even know what mine's going to look like yet, honestly. They just told me to expect a text message. Nice. In conclusion, what I want to tell you is to be aware of MLMs. They're really quite dangerous. And I want you to check out our podcast on all the streaming DSPs, all the streaming platforms, everywhere you get your podcasts, you can get them. And also follow us on Patreon. Make sure to join our Patreon. It's really fun. You'll get a lot of information from Kenneth. You know, just join the Patreon, come to the workshops. They're very safe. You know, you're only going to be in a bunk bed situation with a bunch of other people. It's very safe. Join the Patreon. Remember to just pay attention to like the Patreon, come to the podcast, and we're going to like learn how to avoid scams, guys. We're going to really learn how to get away from all the scams. So that's what I want to just share with you. Thanks. Good night.
Right. Oh, thanks, George. Yeah, George, hook me up with that Liege. I want some Kenneth info if you can.
Yeah. I'll make sure that you guys get up on it, and you know, we're gonna funnel all of our chinchilla profits together, guys.
Yeah, send me a close up of that tattoo like right after you get it.
Eric, your phone's gonna blow up in so many ways.
Thanks, man.
So many ways. All right, thanks.
All right, thanks, George. Thank you, George. That was great. Live from George's house. Who's up next? Peaking Lights has sent our old friends, and they have a new track out. They put together this video for us, and it's pretty rad. Very nice of them to do this.
Thank you, Peaking Lights.
See if I can find it here.
They live in Amsterdam, and this is a new song from them.
Yeah, very cool song.
We miss them.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Very rad. Very nice bike ride there.
Yeah, someone was asking. Yeah, that's in Amsterdam. And that's the, yeah, they're on their way to the store. So we're going to do a little donation time now. And I'm going to put up some donation info. I can't say enough about how rad Bopa is, and I got to know her from the previous Supermoon, and they were suggested that we help them by some people in Oakland, actually Moira Scar. And so just getting to know what they do and how helpful they are, and with all the stuff going on right now, it's just like the best. So I can't say enough about if you donate to them. It's going to go to a really great cause, and every Wednesday, Bopa and volunteers that she works with go out and they give food and they give toiletries and dog food or pet food and just stuff to get people through. So Bopa, thank you. And let's just take a little minute here to look at these beautiful Venmo, Square, and PayPals up here. We could give some money. Give a little here and there. Remember, if you give 20 and you send me a screen grab, or you can get the t-shirt, or I think for 15 you can get the patch or a mask. Let's put some of those up too. Not to get away from it. There's our patches done by Moira Scar. Here's our old t-shirts. Dog not included, but sometimes he's a wild guy. But anyway, $20 for those. Just send it to bewarecat@gmail.com. And then don't forget about the old masks. Those were designed by Moira Scar and donated by Matt's artist. But yeah, who would have ever thought we would need masks? But we do. And here they are. So, I'm gonna leave this up for a little bit longer. Enjoy. I might change our overlay here to something. What? Here's some other stuff. Sorry about that. And let's get our donation thing back up again. That was some card tricks in the winter time. We'll have to figure that one out, why the sound went away. But anyway, we're going to hold this up for a little bit longer, and we got Weasel Walter up next, and it's brand new from him. Eric, do you want to see something about Weasel?
Sure. Yeah, we asked Weasel if he wanted to send something in. He said he would be happy to send some irritainment. So thanks, Weasel.
And it's
live or straight from New York. Here's the Weasel.
Okay, we'll be back in a little while with some more info. Here comes Weasel.
Thank you.
Thank you, Weasel. That was awesome. I'll get it.
Okay.
Dog problem.
We have a dog escape artist. So we have Podblots up next with Susie Poling, and this is footage from her last show when she was in Seattle. And it's live footage shot by some artists that are at the Kame House. And so the video is a collaboration. She did all the abstract images and stuff like that, but I think more is the way it's shot. But anyway, here comes Susie Podblots.
Thanks, Susie.
Thank you so much, Susie.
Thank you.
Well,
thanks, Susie. Awesome as usual.
Very beautiful stuff. So we're going to go back for a little donation time. And let's see here. Some more donations time. Old Santa thinks that if you want to get anything in your stocking, you should probably give to others. Bobo would be a nice person to give to. And Roger's the Rosewater Soup Kitchen. Sometimes, you know, if you can't get out and do stuff, you can always give to the people that can. Back into some stuff now. And next we have Duchess Hot Plate, otherwise known as VEX or Moira Scar. And they were nice enough to do tons of stuff, but also nice enough to do a really great set with saxophone and theremin. So sit back and enjoy.
Thank you.
More Duchess Hot Plate.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so someone asked for the card tricks, and we got them back here. It's a very wintry card trick place here. Thank you so much, you guys. And we're going to go right now to Shaki, who, or Chaki, we're going to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, theys and them, it's the Chucky Christmas Clam Bacon Hanukkah Hoedown! Chucky, he's here to bake some clams now! Chucky! Chucky, he's gonna blaze your hams now! Chucky!
Hey, welcome everyone, and thanks for watching. It's me, Chucky, and this is my first holiday special ever. It's the Chucky Christmas Clam Bake and Hanukkah Hoedown. For all my old friends out there,
thank you for supporting me on this journey.
And for those of you who don't know who I am, nice to meet you. I'm Chucky, and I am a Jewish cowboy.
I am a Jewish cowboy. I eat my latkes with a spoon. I don't ride no horse. I read my Torah by the light of the moon. I am a Jewish cowboy. I eat salami with my cheese. That's right, I don't keep kosher. And you know that mistletoe ain't working on me. So if you want to smooch these lips, I need a bottle of Manischewitz and an eighth of weed. I am a Jewish cowboy. Shalom to all my homies.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Okay, so I've been watching a lot of these Christmas specials for research, right? And I noticed two things. Number one, you need like an overarching plot to bind the whole thing together. And number two, you need a lot of guest stars. Like, you need to bombard the viewer with guest stars. But since I'm stuck in here all alone this year, I guess I'm not gonna be able to have any guest stars. Since no friends could come visit me. This is gonna be one boring Christmas special. Oh, someone's calling on the video phone. Who could it be? Hello? Chalky's Winter Hideaway. Chalky speaking.
Happy holiday, Chalky. I'm just calling you to wish you a happy holiday.
Oh, hi, David. I'm just here doing my holiday special. You know, Christmas, Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, Christmas. What does Christmas mean to you?
Christmas is about being good. It's a fat old man that imitates Jesus with a big white snow white beard. And he tells kids if they're good, they're going to get anything they want for Christmas. And he spoils kids. They build a Christmas tree of all kinds of ornaments on it. And then on Christmas morn, all kinds of packages come from Santa. Old fat, jolly Santa.
Oh, well, I was just singing about being a Jewish cowboy for Hanukkah, you know?
What is Hanukkah?
Oh, I can tell you all about Hanukkah. I just need to get my bass. Oh, here it is.
Way back before JC, there was a tribe called the Maccabees, and they were ruled by the Greeks. It was against the law to be a Jew, so you know what they had to do, but they bit off more than they could chew. They took over the temple at night, and they needed to light the lights, but they only had oil for one night. That's when a miracle occurred, for 8 nights that oil burned. So now I teach you how to honor.
I'm gonna teach you how to light the candle. I'm gonna teach you how to light the candle. I'm gonna teach you how to light the candle. I'm gonna teach you how to light the candle, yeah, hey.
Alright, so you're gonna need a menorah, and you're gonna need some Hanukkah candles and something to light them with. Now kids, please make sure you're with your parents when you light the Hanukkah candles and you don't light the house on fire. I lit the house on fire and I was a kid and it's not fun. And then you want to take the shamash, that's the candle in the middle of the menorah, and you want to light the other candles, whatever night it is, you want to light the amount of corresponding candles with whatever night it is. And you say this prayer, say it with me, here we go. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav yitzivanu l'chadlik ner shel Hanukkah. Woo! All right, it's important you know what you're saying. So here's the English translation from Hebrew. Blessed are you, Adonai our God, sovereign of all who hallows us with miracles, commanding us to kindle the Hanukkah lights. So we're thanking God for the great miracle of the 8 lights burning, and we're symbolizing that with these candles here. Sheesh, can I take a bass solo, please?
I'm hungry. Can I have a sandwich?
You're not even going to mention the song I just sang. I just sang a whole song about Hanukkah for you, and I have candle wax all over my... Yeah, I have some sandwiches right here for you. Here.
Is it from outer space or is it from Earth?
No, they're from Jersey Mike's. They're from Earth, not a sponsor.
I love my sandwich.
Thanks, Chalky.
That was rad. And so so we're going to do another little donation moment. Going to have a little keyboard. Oops. All right. And let's
please click on the app. Right there, yeah. Right in the middle. Hello? Okay.
@gmail.com me. Thanks, guys. All right. We got our next.
Next up, old friend Arrington de Dioniso.
Thank you.
Thanks, Arrington. Awesome.
Oh, oh, oh. Thank you so much. It was great. Very cool to see your work inside your hat.
So next up, we have a new band called Night Fever. And it may or may not be myself, Liz, and our friend Dave.
Donations tonight. I was just typing with Bopa and we're doing pretty good, but we could use some more. And let's just take a few minutes to find our phones and find some ways. Change the overlay, see if that helps. But yeah, I can't say enough about what they do, and I kind of feel like it's our best way we can help someone is someone that you know and someplace small, and they have a great effect on her, the folks that are right around there. So, and don't forget, we got patches, and we got Superman t-shirts and dogs, and we also have masks. So if you type in bewarecat@gmail.com and send me a screen grab for 15 or for 20 for a t-shirt, and I think it's also 15 for the mask, we'll be doing pretty good. So, yeah, that's kind of why, I mean, we love all the art and all the bands and stuff, but this is kind of the reason we really want to do. So give, give, give. Little bits, lots. And we'll check in with both later to see how we're doing. All right. So next, we have Plaque Play coming up. And Eric, do you want to say something about this?
Yeah. Out of Detroit. Old friend. Haven't seen him for a long time, but he rules. Let's hear it.
From the Folsom Street Fair a while back, and God, remember the Folsom Street Fair? It's been a while. It's been a while since we get to do much. All right, so we got God Tease coming up next, and this is from Luna, and she is just kind of a blend of the city, psychedelia. It was filmed on location with Anais Sohanian, and I think you'll really like it. It's pretty wild and also really pretty. So here we go. This is Luna from God Tease.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, God Tease. That was a great job. Thank you. All right. Next we got Margie Stibbe, and she does all kind of stuff. She's a multidisciplinary artist. She does video, performance. She does a really cool K-Chun radio kind of get together every Friday if you're ever looking for something to do. But here she comes. She did a great performance for us. This is new.
I'm Vina Virago, aka Punk Rock Cougar, aka Dirty Disco Dancer, and the title of my piece is Mating Ritual. Roses are red, violets are blue, you're a hot young stud. And I wanna get with you. Hit it!
Heading in.
Yeah, body double.
Pretty cool. And seems like we had the video editor showing up over here. So nice, that was great to have. Yeah, pretty cool. So we're gonna go back into some donation moments. And, you know, gotta think about the world. There's a lot of different people out there in the world. Some people need help, some people can help. Someday we're all gonna be old and we'll probably need help. So, let's all hope it works out. But it is important to give when we can. So let's give when we can. There was this overlay I was looking for. I'm going to try to find it over here. Had some Jane Fonda doing some stretches and stuff, but I think this is it. Here she is. All right, so let's think for a little bit. Think if we have a little extra somewhere we can give. Remember, we do have t-shirts, masks, and patches going your way. Did another music for us, but here comes one more from Foreign Fire.
ביום האלוהים על אברהם קורא בסופו לא לקרוא את שמו קורא כי קורא שמו ולכתי אותו גם נותנתי ממנו לחובן ולכתי הו הו יזור את זוהי Abraham al panu al wayam al bani ba al den ne ashalom walen wey karo abba ki fein shono tene.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Born Fire. Like I said, they're on Instagram. And go check them out. They post stuff all the time, and it's usually pretty cool. Different visuals, sometimes more chants, but it's always really great. So we've got Alona Berger and Andrew Wingler up next, and I cannot say enough about either one of those people. Miss Alona very much, and she's been up in San Francisco for a bit. And she's been doing a lot of guitar and Russian songs. Here we go. Oh, and by the way, this is actually a Russian animation called The Third Planet, if you ever want to check it out. It's pretty rad. Yeah, so fitting. Here we go. That was awesome, Alona. Thank you. It's so beautiful. And I remember when you were just talking about learning some of this stuff, and now it's like you're It's like you've been doing it for a long time. It sounds really great. Okay, so I think we might do, we've got Peter Kalish up next, and this is a from a performance from 2018, and it's pretty amazing. Thank you, Peter, for sending and being supportive. Let's see here. Here we go. Coming up, Peter Kalish.
Thank you.
Amazing. Thank you, Peter, so much. That looked like a lot of fun and also pretty nuts, but beautiful too. Okay, so just because we're kind of getting near the end, we have a few more people left. We have Almighty Op next, who is pretty awesome as well, and a lot of puppet kind of beautiful stuff. If you don't follow them already on Instagram, you should check them out. But we're gonna sideline a little for a second and do some more auction stuff. Auction stuff. We got patches, $15 donation. We're getting some emails about those, so you gotta act quick on this. And we still have a few t-shirts left, guys. But like I said, the dog's not part of the package there, nor is this headless guy. But the t-shirts, we've got mediums and larges. Pretty cozy, nice green, get you through your day. And we finally also have beautiful masks. And these were designed by Morris Scar, as were the patches, but these were also donated by Matt's from the Bay Area. So thanks, you guys. So just email me at bewarecat@gmail.com with your proof of purchase. That's what we want to see. And we'll send those out to you. Oh, yeah, I guess you got to send me your address. But we'll figure that out. So for now, let's throw this up for a little bit. And you guys can enjoy a little Third Planet with Jane Fonda in the background.
Laughing endlessly at where you think you'll be, footloose and fancy free, on the right side of history. Split them all in half, then split those halves in half. They don't stand a chance, in fact they laid us in the task. Tear themselves apart with nonsense, drugs, and art, believing they're the cure as they help us close the door. The way to control the opposition is to lead it. The people who touch your heart are mostly double agents. Is to lead it. Swallow your pride, realize you had fallen for it. You had fallen for it. You had fallen for it. You had fallen for it.
Funding both the sides.
everything's aligned. Just watch them welcome their demise. Bodies filled with dope. What's real, no one will know. Hearts and heads we own. It's going where we say it goes. The way to control the opposition is to lead it. The people who touch your heart are mostly double agents. The way to control the opposition is to lead it. Swallow your pride, realize you had fallen for it. 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 You had fallen for it.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
That's beautiful. I hope I got the right one. We had a lot of videos coming through on Almighty App, but we love it. Thank you. That was made fresh for us, and we appreciate it very much.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's really cool. And you got to check out their Instagram. There's amazing puppets and music, and it seems like live shows on Saturday evenings are happening most of the time. They're really great. Anyway, we got Jason Winfield up next. Here we go.
Chimney Factory. It doesn't matter. Chimney Factory. Chimney Factory. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Chimney Factory. It doesn't matter. Hollow us out from within. And you better believe the communist Chinese are behind this whole climate change nonsense. Man-made climate change. They don't give a damn. They think it's terrific. And so these lawsuits, these battles that are going on, that are degraded, and the people who bring them are diminished. Whether it's the pseudo-conservative reprobates at National Review, whether it's the low IQ teenagers at Mediaite, whether it's the Soros-funded hack jobs over there at the Media Matters, or whether it's the same hackneyed reprobate media in our own country. They always seem to be on the wrong side, don't they? More when I return. I'll be right back.
If you try, you'll find me where the sky meets the sea. Here am I, your special island. Come to me, come to me. Belly high, belly high, belly high.
Whether it's the same hackneyed reprobate media in our own country, they always seem to be on the wrong side, don't they? More when I return. I'll be right back.
Thanks, Jason.
Thanks.
So that was Real AM Radio from Virginia Beach, East Coast, when he was back visiting his family. So that's the world. And we're going to do a little more donation time because we've only got two more people left. We've got V Polly and My Heart and Inverted Flame. So let's try to get a few more dollars for Bopa. We've done pretty good. We could do some more. And I've gotten a lot of requests for the masks and for everything else, so let's keep going. And we do have a couple t-shirts left. The masks may be gone. I'm not sure. We can try to still get some of those. Everybody, there's so much good stuff tonight. It was really hard to figure out how to order it and stuff, but there's not a dull moment, like I was saying. Here we go, V Polly.
Thank you.
obsessive palate regression, memory of past events, informed the sensory capacities of the individual, constructing the present reality and assuring a recognizable future. The definition of an object by an observer was also controlled to a limited degree by the hypnotizing curse of the object being observed. In other words, the object emitted subtle frequencies. The building was renovated to withstand seismic impact. The building was renovated to withstand seismic impact.
Thank you.
Okay, so we've got one more after right now, but we're going to do a little bit of the last bits of donation. And do you want to play?
Oh, and sorry again to the people who were wanting to watch on Twitch. We tried to get that working and couldn't get it, but maybe next time.
We had some major issues, you guys. I'm so sorry. So everyone, we've been online talking about it already in the background, but yeah, we're gonna try to broadcast again on Twitch maybe tomorrow, because we'll have this broadcast recorded, so we might just do it again tomorrow and broadcast it out. But yeah, we had some weird sign-in issues with Restream, but we're very sorry. But we did get a lot of viewers, and we're still gonna get a few more now. And let's put up our donation information. Also, just want to say thank you to everybody. It's pretty amazing how creative everyone is and how awesome everyone is. And, like, freaking badass everyone is that they make all this stuff. Every single person. So thank you very much. And glad people got to connect today and say hello. So that's part of it too, and we love it. So thanks for listening to us. But anyway, let's give a few more dollars. And one good thing is that this will be up forever, or for a while on YouTube. So if people come back, they can give again. You can share this with your friends. It'll be up for a while. And we'll try to make some more happen here for Bopa and Rogers and Rose Rogers Super Kitchen. So. So can we just talk about Xanadu for a second? This is from Xanadu. I don't know. I've been into Bob Fosse, Xanadu's, any kind of dance stuff. And I don't know, they put, what's his name on skates? The guy from Singing in the Rain, Gene Kelly. He's like skating around in this movie. If you want to see some really cool shit, there he is right there, waving. Xanadu. I don't know. Okay, so let's give it a little bit more time. And then we're going to go to My Heart, An Inverted Flame. And again, thank you to everybody. Thank you.
Wow, very cool.
That was beautiful and like a bad dream, but really beautiful too at the same time. I love this, love the crazy cloud moments. Beautiful. So do you want to talk about the Twitch part?
So that's it for the show. And then as soon as we finish here, we'll upload it to the Twitch channel and it'll be available there for, I think, 2 weeks, I think, before they auto-delete.
Yeah, we're going to put it up there, and it might be too late for some people, but we're hoping that, you know, the people that weren't able to watch it there can catch it there. So we're sorry about the Twitch. Anyway, but the show was awesome, you guys. Thank you so much. And it's going to live up on YouTube for... until the end of the world. So if you didn't get a chance to donate tonight, you can always donate tomorrow. We'll post all the information for that in the description. And yeah, such a beautiful show. Thanks to you guys and happy solstice.
Thanks for everyone sending stuff in. Amazing. And thanks for everyone watching.
Yeah. All right, take care.
Night.